Ruth here. This is a little late. A few months. Or more. Depends when I actually upload this. But I thought I'd open this up in its own video. I did a cursory, slideshow because I couldn't bother to actually video anything. This was what I got for my... Well, some of the stuff that I got for my birthday. So I'll just do some little opening video. You know, might as well. So here is a show memo, like a mini embossing kind of letter thing. I thought it was cool. And embossing label maker. That's the word. So I thought I might as well open it up because, you know, on camera and in here. Why not? Will be interesting. Well, that's useful. A crease and opened it up for me. And as you know, I am late, so I should probably keep this anyway just in case. It's hard to use it. We'll set it up. Or whatever, so I'll just put off this side for a sec. It's very nice foiling on the box too. And I guess I don't need instructions, but I've got instructions on it as well. 6 steps, and it comes with pictures, which is nice. This is what it looks like. So, align before use. I like it. That's aligned. Yes. That looks like it's aligned anyway. Just take that off. It's already got black inside. So just need to line up, I guess, the letter, and press. And I'm guessing all the way over here is a space. Then I'll take some getting used to, I guess. I have to try again. quite how it's supposed to end up looking, but I almost got it, I guess. I mean, it's interesting looking. And it's self-adhesive. You just peel off the backing and stick it to wherever. Yeah. So, yeah, that's a mess up, but it's interesting. Should I try it again? Hopefully it will it'll be better. Maybe. Hopefully. See, what was I doing? Yes, space over here. One thing about these is that you can't have typos because that's not going to be helpful because you can't backspace. It's a bit better. That is. I'm not really sure why some of it's not quite straight, but anyway. Yeah, so that's how I use it. So I'll keep them both. They still look pretty cool on a card, kind of, maybe. And I have to go say hi to my brother that came home for a visit. So yes, I did cut it out. It came with colors too, which is nice. So the colors it came with, and I can open this. Greeny blue, green, black, and more of a pink than red. Okay. That was, I don't know, for red. Can't remember what it said the colors would be, so, to be honest. Anyway, I can get these back in without dropping them. I guess you're supposed to use that first. How's the one you do? Okay. So here's this bit. And that bit. And then replace the little tape. And there's the problems and solutions. Print is not clear. The handle is not pressed hard enough. Press the handle firmly. Label tape is not installed correctly. Reinstall the label tape. Incorrect printing due to poor alignment of the upper and lower discs. Rotate the dial to align the disc. Align the scissor icons of the upper and lower discs. Turning the dial too fast may distort the prints or ghost it. That's why. Okay. I got to go something. And let's see. I guess the Y is ghosting. Still looks cool though. Okay. Do not press the handle when removing the label tape. Do not press the handle when turning the disc. Well, that's the reason pressing the handle incorrectly. Disc is stuck or label is stuck. It won't print. It's not, the label tape is not installed. And the output of the slot machine is clogged with the label tape residue. Check if the tape is inserted correctly. Use a pair of tweezers to remove tape residue. Fairly straightforward. How to prevent tape residue from accumulating inside the machine. Label tape is not cut properly, remains inside the machine. Do not cut tape more than once. Label tape may get stuck between the input and output slots. 1. Cut the tape cleanly. 2. Open the rear lid. Check the amount of adhesive tape remaining. When there is a label, little label left, replace it immediately. Okay. Anyway, so that's that. So I'll keep the instructions in here because, yeah. And my sister also got me these. This set. So I've got some more black ones, and we've got gold one, another gold one, so two black, two gold, one silver, and one white. So what is it? One white. And said just kind of go white. I mean, I guess it's embossing, it pushes through, so I don't know. So, I'll put the rest in here. And close. It wants to be in here. There we go. So that is that opening done. So I'll put this somewhere. Uh-huh. Okay, so this is the Stamp Like a Champ. It says down there, Stamp Easy Plus Stamp Platform. Laysen, is that how you say it? That's the brand. Laysen Creative, isn't it? It says, for easy and precise stamping with all clean and clear stamps. Ideal for layered stamping designs and re-inking for full coverage. Cover can be detached and used as a stamping block. Idle status. So it's, and there's a press down. Height variation 2.3 to 8.5 millimeters. Stamping area 22 centimeters by 16.6 centimeters. And which is 8.65 by 6.5 inches. And why is a point a comma? Sometimes I wonder why they do that. Though this was bought using my friend's Amazon gift card she gave me for my birthday. So I guess it's sort of a birthday present. And the one thing that's annoying is that, besides it being sticky, Amazon or whoever posted this, as you can see the label right here. So they didn't put it in a mailer bag or anything, they just posted this. And it's packed, which is, I think, is kind of lazy and very annoying, but there we go. So it's got a raised edge, paper alignment, centimeters and inches, which is good. Open edged on three sides, allows accurate stamping on various sized surfaces. Full magnetic base, two handy magnets to secure your project in place when stamping. Anti-slip base ensures a sturdy platform when stamping. The rest of it is not an inch. Yes, so that's basically it. Instructions included. Crafted to smile. Get inspired. There's a mason-creative.com. You can find them there. Not sponsored or anything, but I thought might as well just say it. You know. Let's open this up. Magnetic there. Yes, I kind of really. Okay, I can just get distracted doing that. Okay, instructions. Fix paper with magnet. Magnets with position and stamps where desired. Press down and clear cover to pick up the stamp. Remove clear cover from the base and apply ink to the stamp. Place cover on the base and apply equal pressure to the ink to ink your project. If you didn't receive a desired result after inking once, just re-ink in the same position. As normal, press down, kind of showed by the band on it. Yes, that's the basic instructions. I don't have anything cut the sides. I did keep some cards. I did get out some cardstock to thing. So this is the smooth side, so this is textured side. I think I stamped on this side. So like you can remove it. Here are the magnets. And it's nice that they have the little lift up kind of tab, you know? So let's just, oh, as a ruler here, and sort it up here. Yeah, can't see it. It is there. So let me just say then, like, what you do is you have a stamp and you go like that. Let's use a stamp, shall we? I just, hopefully things won't keep falling off places. I put that right there. I actually got this recently. It's the only time I got this. And it is, so can I just, here it is, Memento Tuxedo Black. A Skin Echo brand, I believe. Very nice, very nice. So I'll use this. I guess I'll get one of my stamps I got for. I'm not gonna show you all of this. How about that? Is this all I got from, well, if you can see the brand, Spellbinders, for my birthday, sort of, but like, technically I bought it for myself, really, but I was gonna buy it anyway, not just for my birthday, but. Got a few stamp sentiments, got cute bunnies. What do you want to stamp that? I have the coordinating dies with the pocket bunny. Got some more stamps. This is like the old school notes, it says. Coordinating die with that. I need to buy a Platinum 6 to actually use the dies. I can still use the stamps just fine for now. This is the hot foil plate and die set. This is a Glimmer Edge Rose foil and die set as well. Yes. Yep. That's the butterfly one. Here's another butterfly one. Because I haven't done an open video of it yet, but I do have a glimmer foil system. I just need to get the Platinum 6. I'm planning to get the new improved one, which is the 8.5 inch one, instead of the smaller 6 inch one. So that's what these look like. It's got the hot foil, and it has two plates and four die cutting bits. Then we have the embossing folders. So I got this one because it is small, but I do really like it. It's really pretty. It's got snowflakes. This is a 3D embossing folder. Don't think this is a 3D one. No, just normal, I think. This is a 3D one. This looks so cool. And this one. Tiled motif. This one just called 3D Embossing Flurry of Snowflakes. Yeah, there's the word. Title's down there. And you can find these in the past club kits section in Spellbinders website. This one was on March 23. This is just fine in the embossing folder section. And like, let's see, just find it in the hot foil section for these. Glimmer of the Month, obviously, in the past kit ones. This is March 22. Oh, March 23, March 22. I didn't notice that, actually. And February 22. Is that February 23? October 21. Hmm. Interesting. So, I will use my dice. Because I've been told that the memento ink is good for those, it's a good stamp that you can color things in too. Or stuff. So, isn't it cute? Aren't they cute? Cute bunnies. I open it just to have it closed on it. And do this is you, I guess, you move the acetate from the back and you choose the ones you want. So, yes. Yes, you just pull it off. I guess I'll use the top one too. And I, on the recent card maker success summit or whatever, that you're supposed to season your stamps. So, it basically has run your finger over it. Like get off the plastic residue or something. The, you know, the plastic manufacturing residue, I guess. Cool. I guess I don't want to waste paper or anything. So I'll just do that because I might cut it out. Just like the click. So like that. Turn the, get that back up. So I'll use my ink and just hopefully this ink is looks like it's sinking. Let's see what it looks like. I'll zoom in, shall I? Make it more, I don't know, see it better. There, right? So, let's get the camera in focus. That looks lovely, doesn't it? One more ink. Might as well do the whole thing. That's good. This is the flower supposed to be. So it's that side. Is it supposed to look like that one? No, there's still a little bit of space. I'm not sorry, it's just my eyes. And it's entirely possible too. But I think it's supposed to be. It's just that tiny flower right in the corner. Who knows? That was a little better. Oh, that's cute. I wonder, is there any ink left on it? I don't think so. Well, maybe a tiny bit. I probably should have a towel or something. So anyway. Dry. That was on me before. Not this. Completely dry. So it's a fast drying one, this one, I believe I said. And about it. Yes. Acid free, fade resistant, water based, fast drying dye ink. So that's cool. So I do wonder. I place it down here. Is there any more? Oops, not there. Is there any more ink on it at all? Tiny bit. That is nice. A faded kind of thing going on there. Also helps to get rid of the ink on the stick too. There's still some left on. Probably should have been talking about my finger.
Should have, yeah.
Something done. Washing.
Okay.
Hopefully this side of the room, and I can both get it. So, it's nice. And we'll save this for the next opening when I have something I'm opening, and I'll show you what I do with it. So, it's great. So, I'll leave it on there for now because I do need to clean. So yes, that I believe is everything, I guess. It works lovely. Get the rest of the ink off. Is it clear? This one. So obviously, as it said, you can take it off and use it as an acrylic. Fidget toy, you know? What's it called? Spring kind of thing, mechanism. So, just place it back. Probably not as aligned as it used to be when it was in there. We'll just place it back. On there. Put the acetate back there. That's basically... Well, this one basically is not aligned at all, but it's fine. So for now, I'll just wash that cuts out. And the okay, that's just weird and very distracting. Cause like the from what I can tell from watching, this I think the first one ever made, or at least the most popular one, is called a Misty. This is basically the same thing, but it was hinged onto, the Misty's hinged, and it opens like that. Oh, like, it doesn't come off like this, which I wanted, besides it being magnetic, and clicks into place. It also is a springboard, so magnetic and spring is really fun to play with too. So I thought, you know, and also I wanted it to be not attached because then it'd be easier for me to ink it and reposition if I wanted to. I am still getting distracted. Okay, so move this off to the side and, or way off to the side, not on the desk. Then I'll be having another opening video and I'll show you what I need this page for. So thank you for watching, like, subscribe for more. We have double phone notifications. Oh, yeah. While I was taking pictures, I forgot to mention, but this is a very nice foam. As I mentioned in the box, the non-slip grip or whatever. So this is the foam pad on the back. So it doesn't move, like, at all. Moving my desk. So yes.